everybody. Welcome to Effort of Reformed Presbyterian Church. My name is Josh Falk. I'm a member here. I also had the unique privilege to be in New Song a long time ago, back in 2000. We were actually here in 2008, I believe. I hope all of you are ready for a really neat experience, I think. New Song does a pretty good job of introducing themselves, so I won't spend too much time doing that, but again, welcome, New Song.
Junior Social Studies Education and Biblical Studies Supple major from Freedom, Pennsylvania.
I'm Rachel Miller, and I'm a Junior Social Services major from Dubois, Pennsylvania.
I'm Emmanuel Berkovich, and I'm a Junior Music Education major from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania.
And I'm Priscilla Joseph. I am a Senior Music and Psychology Double major from Milton, Georgia. Today our concert will consist of a combination of psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs, and we'll also have some skits in the middle. There were times in my life where I've struggled to express myself, whether it's communicating my thoughts clearly or coping with emotions so deep that I don't have words. But thankfully, God knows me, and He knows all of us better than we know ourselves, and He has given us words to express these thoughts, the Psalms. As scripture, they are God's words to us, but they're also given as our words back to Him. The Psalms contain a wide array of emotion. Fear, doubt, anger, grief, triumph, joy, praise. These are words that God has given us to express our souls before Him. And they consistently point us back to Jesus, as many of them contain promises that He has fulfilled, and they teach us about God's character and the relationship between Father and Son. Jesus Himself often quotes the Psalms in the New Testament. Singing the Psalms is such a wonderful opportunity to memorize scripture, to express ourselves in the words God gave to us, and to sing with Jesus in his praises. Having experienced how singing the Psalms has strengthened our walk with the Lord, we'd like to sing several of them today and share this blessing with you. The first will be Psalm 130.
For your our next piece says, "It doesn't take an earthquake to shake the ground we stand on." And that's very true. We can be shaken by current events, losing a job, or honestly just a really hard day. But this song is a great reminder for us to hold on to the Rock of Ages, who can save us from anything that might shake us. God is our rock that we can joyfully hold on to.
You've got to hold on to the Rock of Ages. Hold on to the cornerstone. Stand strong on the sure foundations, surrounded by the fortress strong. When all the storms of life are raging, hold on to the rock.
You've got to
declaring his glory to those who need to hear it, which is all of us.
Declare his glory among the heathen, his wonders among the people, for the Lord is great, and greatly to be praised. He is to be feared above all gods, for the gods of the nations are idols. His glory among the heathen, his
gospel song called Down to the River to Pray. Although the exact origin is unknown, it is believed to have been written by African-American slaves, possibly coded with messages of escaping by way of the river and stars. This song beautifully captures the spirit of a simple, heartfelt plea for renewal, and it's a wonderful reminder that it is the Lord who shows us the way in truth and love.
As I went down to the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown, good Lord, show me the way. Oh, sisters, let's go down, let's go down, come on down. Oh,
by the phrase, be still my soul. I need the reminder to slow down, focus on God, know that He is in control, and trust in His timing. This is be still my soul.
Be still.
under though the earth gives way. These are the words found in Psalm 46. To say the least, we are living in very unprecedented times, and it may often feel like the earth is giving way, but it is important for us to remember where our hope is. The exact comfort that we seek is found in Psalm 46. As a naturally anxious person, I have been drawn to this psalm my entire life, and I've looked at this psalm more times this year alone than I ever have. Though the waters roar and the mountains tremble, we stand still, knowing that He, the Almighty God of Jacob, is our stronghold.
Storytelling. He Here are a few short skits to help convey God's truth through both drama and comedy. The New Testament opens with a list of names, the genealogy of Jesus Christ, the son of David, the son of Abraham. This genealogy provides a kind of fast forward through the famous characters in the redemptive history of the Old Testament, and shows how Jesus is truly the promised Messiah that would descend from the lines of Abraham's family and the people of Israel. However, if we hone in on the first third of Jesus' genealogy, we notice something peculiar. The names of two women who were not born into Israelite families. This scripture explains that a Jew named Salmon and a foreigner named Rahab had a son named Boaz, and that Boaz also married a foreigner named Ruth, who gave birth to Obed, the grandfather of King David, the line through which the Messiah would come. Even in the Old Testament, when God dwelt in his temple in a particular nation, he extended grace to anyone who would call upon him and keep his word. Here are the stories of the two foreign women who sought to do exactly that. Oh, Obed, my sweet gift from God.
Ruth, what a beautiful little boy he is.
It's your boy's boy, Rahab. When I look at him, I see Boaz's eyes, and I'll pray I'll be just as good as a mother to him as you are to Boaz, so he'll grow up to be just as kind.
Oh, Ruth, I did so many wrongs, yet God was gracious to spare my life, and even more gracious to give me a wonderful husband and son.
And now a grandson. Would you like to hold him?
Would I ever? Oh, little Obed, you are such a wonder.
I keep asking myself why I should be so blessed. I'm a foreigner, a Moabite, and now I'm a Jewish mama.
You ask why you're so blessed. What about me? I'm a Canaanite, an enemy from Jericho, and now I'm a Jewish grandma. Oh, Obed, I cannot tell you how much I love you. You are a gift from God who extends his scarlet cord of redemption to a whole new generation.
Naomi, his other grandma, also calls Obed a gift from God. She's thrilled to have a grandson. When her sons and husband died in Moab, she felt forsaken. She had no idea how to survive.
She wouldn't have survived if you hadn't come back to Bethlehem with her. You were her helper in putting her life back together and her companion in grief.
It's also amazing. When Boaz saw me in his fields and found out that I was Naomi's daughter-in-law, he told the workers to leave extra grain for me. You should have seen the look on Naomi's face when she saw how much barley I came home with that first day.
And you should have heard what Boaz said about you. Your kindness and caring for Naomi and your faith in God caught his attention.
Boaz was gracious and protected me while I worked in his fields. God has been so good.
Ruth, come see the memory blanket that I made for little Obed.
A memory blanket? Sounds interesting.
I started with a simple fleece, nothing fancy or fine. Just something soft and warm, like our family is now.
Even that's a gift, isn't it, Rahab? I'm so happy I can hardly stand it.
Me too. I had a troubled childhood, you know. They called me the Scarlet Harlot of Jericho. I tried finding happiness in all the wrong places. I once owned a house in Jericho. The walls were strong and thick. I wore fancy clothes and flashy jewelry. I looked good on the outside, but I was empty and miserable on the inside.
Oh, Rahab.
And the men that came to see me, they were so hollow, not to mention terrified. We'd heard how God had dried up the Red Sea for the Israelites when they left Egypt. And we'd heard how God had given them victory over the nations. When the men camped across the Jordan River from Jericho, our city went on high alert.
So why did you hide the spies?
It was my moment of destiny. I had to choose, the spies or the soldiers. Deep down, I knew the God of the Israelites was the true God. So I hid the men under stalks of flax that were drying on my roof, and I helped them escape from a rope that was hanging from my window. I wanted to serve God, not fight with him anymore.
You saved those spies' lives, Rahab.
And they saved mine. They told me to hang a scarlet cord from my window, and that when they attacked, they would rescue my family. This was my scarlet cord of redemption.
And your deliverance when the walls fell.
Yes, and wonders of wonders, Salomon, one of the Jewish spies, not only rescued my family, but he also married me.
And you gave birth to Boaz.
Ruth, come look at the fields of wheat and grain I've included on this blanket so you can tell little Obed your love story.
As our kinsman redeemer, Boaz extended that scarlet cord of redemption to Naomi and me. He renewed our hope, and now I have a Jewish son.
Oh, Ruth, who can imagine the ways of the Almighty?
Or think of a better way to teach little Obed about him.
This little boy is such a wonder.
Such a miracle. Such a joy.
But serving the true God is an even greater wonder, a marvelous miracle, an eternal joy.
Are you sure? Do you have the right kind of insurance?
Do you have hole in your soul insurance? Because if you don't,
well,
fine, we'll fill the hole.
You know, Doctor, the last physician I worked for.
Quiet in the OR! Quiet in the OR! Thank you. Now, there are many options we could take to go about doing this. I would suggest romance.
Romance?
Romance. Romance will fill the hole.
So they say.
Ow! Ow, you stuck me with a thorn.
Look, bud, that's just the nature of romance. Now quit being a baby and take your medicine.
Nice work, Doctor.
Oh, you ain't seen nothing yet. Music!
Music.
Like old school R&B?
Doctor, you can't fill a hole in the soul with music.
People do it all the time. Concert tickets, eclectically cool music playlists, all different sorts of things. And that was the newest, coolest thing, too. Hip-hop, country, western.
That's not going to work.
I guess you're right. Garth Brooks dropping a rap in saggy jeans.
No, I mean, it's not going to fill the hole.
Listen here. Are you the doctor here? I think not. Career.
Career.
Gotta have that six-figure salary. That's why I became a doctor. Hobby. I don't know what to do with these. Television.
Television. Doctor, surely I'll take more than television.
Fine. Where did I put it? Internet streaming television.
Internet streaming.
So picky.
Doctor, I don't feel any different.
The hole is still there, Doctor.
I think we should try convincing him there's no hole in his soul at all. That sometimes works. How's our supply of denial?
We have plenty, Doctor.
I know we do. We always have plenty, even when we deny it.
Wait a minute, Doctor. His chart says that he's terminal.
Terminal? The hole in my soul is terminal? I'm dying? I want a second opinion.
Yeah, so do I.
I'm sorry to inform you, sir, but you have sin all over the place in there.
Sin?
Yes, sir, very toxic. It's eating away at the hole and making it bigger all the time. Nothing is going to fill the hole unless we also get that sin removed.
Well, the sin is localized, right?
You wish. Dude, according to these charts, your sin is seriously widespread. I mean, like, wow.
Can't anything be done?
By golly, nurse, it's time for radical therapy. Church!
Church? That's a church?
Well, church shopping network, actually. You choose your own. You never know which one will actually fill the hole. So, as you can see, there's churches sorted by denomination, sorted by Friday night bowling leagues, by postmodern theology, and by worship styles as well. And here's one that worships in hip-hop country western.
Cool! And they've got a service starting in half an hour.
Well, what are we waiting for? Let's blow this popsicle stand. Congratulations, sir. You're healed. No need to thank me.
Are you healed?
Apparently.
I feel sicker than ever.
Look, there's this other physician right now.
Yeah?
Yeah, and he's, well, he's pretty amazing.
A specialist, huh?
I could say that.
I don't know what good it would do. You can hurt the man. I'm as good as dead unless someone goes in there and removes all the sin.
Well, that's the amazing thing about him. He can do that.
So he says.
No, no. I've seen him do it before. I've seen him take people who were terminally ill with sin and return them to abundant life. I've seen him heal tons of addicts. Truth is, I've seen him heal just about anything. From relationships to broken hearts, children going through rebellious phases. I mean, these people can tell you.
So, what good is all this then?
I'm afraid that's just all various forms of anesthesia.
I don't know about the specialist, man. I mean, how much will it cost?
Well, it'll cost you everything. But everything is not as much as it sounds. You've got whole soul insurance.
I do?
You do.
People were created by God to be worshipers. God has given us many good things on this earth, and it is often easy to worship things created rather than their creator. Yet the creation itself can never truly satisfy us, and we are always left longing for something more. These things, even if they are good things, cannot save our souls. Jesus says, "I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me shall not hunger, and whoever believes in me shall never thirst."
Hello, everyone. My name is Lindsay Schaefer, and on behalf of New Song and Geneva College, I just want to say thank you so much for having us. It's great to be in a place where we have been several times. I actually was in the group with Josh, who stood up and welcomed everyone back in 2008 when we came to this church. So it's really great to be back in a place that we know so well. Thank you for always welcoming us with open arms. For those of you that don't know, though, New Song has been a part of Geneva College for 44 years now. So we've been blessed to do this every summer almost since 1977, with the exception of last summer because of COVID. So we're especially excited this year to be back. We're just so grateful for the Lord's provision that we could bring this program to you tonight. At this time, I also just want to talk briefly about Geneva College, and if you look at the back of your program, that's just a really great place to start if you don't know anything about us. We're a small Christian liberal arts college associated with the Reformed Presbyterian Church in North America, and we are located about 45 minutes outside of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. We're in Beaver Falls, as Lily mentioned earlier. We are a small Christian liberal arts college. That means we have degrees in the liberal arts, like humanities and Bible and things like that, but we also offer a lot of majors in the STEM disciplines. Engineering is one of our largest majors, and we have other things in between, like business and communications and education. I was an education major. But there is one thing that ties all of our majors together at Geneva, and that's that the professors teach with the Lordship of Jesus Christ in mind. So whether you're studying to be a teacher, or you're studying to be a pastor, or an engineer, all the things that you do in your job and in your life are to be done to glorify God and love Him and love your neighbor. And I just want to testify to you that this is something that I think Geneva does really well. They don't just say that they do it and then do something else. I graduated almost 10 years ago, and while I was really thankful to get a good degree that helped me to get a job that I feel like I do an okay job at as a music teacher, more than that, I've been really grateful for the way that my professors taught from the Bible, whether I was in a music class or a Bible class or a math class. And that's something I found myself to be really grateful for in recent years, as you know, the world seems to be changing and it's hard to evaluate what's going on around you. I've been most thankful for those core classes that I got at Geneva and the way that my professors prepared me for a difficult life as a Christian. And so that's something I'm really thankful for, but I would encourage you to talk to any of these students that are here. They would love to share with you what the Lord is doing in their lives at Geneva. Even if you don't know anyone that's looking at college, or you know, you're not looking at college, they would still just love to share with you about the ministry that Geneva is to them and the way that they are being prepped to go out to the world. So we brought a table in the back too. We have CDs and things for sale, but we also have stuff for free to give away. If you know anyone that is looking for information about Geneva, we'd love to share that with you. So I hope you enjoy the rest of the concert. I'm going to turn it back over to New Song.
sometimes the best things are found in the most unexpected places. A long time ago, a New Song group went to a gas station, where they ran into another singing group. The two groups decided to share songs together, and it was there that the other group introduced a New Song to Freedom, which is a song that introduces our hearts to the return of the hope of true freedom, which is Jesus Christ. To help keep this tribe a true tradition, if there are any New Song alumni in the audience, feel free to come up here and join us for this song.
Though my heart and flesh may fail.
the Lord's holiness. Because the Lord cannot accept sin, he must not also accept those who refuse to confess their sin. However, throughout the psalm, it gives examples such as Moses and Aaron and Samuel, who all confess their sins before the Lord, and the Lord forgives them. So let us follow their example and confess our sins before the Lord, so we can exalt the Lord without anything holding us back. This is Psalm 99.
Let the nations tremble, for the Lord is reigning from his throne above the angels. Let the earth be shaken, high above all nations, is the Lord great King in Zion. Let them all praise your name, awesome and majestic, for he is most holy. King of might and power, he whose strength loves justice, equity you have.
Over the course of the last year, I have learned a great deal about my own weaknesses, and through that, I'm only beginning to understand God's strength and truly understand his unconditional love for us. In a culture that promotes independence and success by our own works, this hymn is a confession of our inability to save ourselves. The Greek word tetelestai is what Jesus uttered with his final breath. It is commonly translated as, "It is finished," but can also be used to indicate that a bill is paid in full. The cost of our sin is death and hell, but by Christ's sacrifice on the cross, the debt of our sin is paid in full, and we can rest in the fact that God is the one in control amidst all of our weaknesses. This is Jesus paid it all.
Child of weakness, watch and pray.
Psalm 23 describes God as our protector and guide in living righteously and in fighting temptation until we arrive at last at a victory feast that he himself prepares for us. We are comforted even as we long for eternal rest in his presence. This is Psalm 23.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me lie down in green pastures. He leads me by still
gifts, whether that be big or small.
Thank you.
wanted to thank you all for coming. It's been such a pleasure singing for you all. As people who live in a fallen world, we tend to prioritize our own needs, wants, and comforts above the Lord. We think these things will satisfy us, but in reality, the only thing that can truly fulfill us is the Lord, and we need to give our lives to Him and ask Him for help in confronting our idols. I Shall Not Want tells us that God can and will deliver us from these things when we taste His goodness and give Him full control over our lives. This is I Shall Not Want.